What's up, guys? Back with another Twinmotion tutorial. I'm going to show you how to add some detail to your 3D scenes. And stick around because I'm going to show you how to use the path tracer as well. Let's get right into the video. All right, so the first thing we want to do is add some detail. And what I mean by detail is adding some context to our scene. So let's see what we got in the Twinmotion library. So we're gonna go to home, we're gonna go to backyard, and then we're gonna go to accessories. So this is kind of where they house some of their objects or outdoors assets. So we're gonna go to accessories. And I don't like to use this garden hole. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of added some context to our scene. All right, so let's see what else we can add. We can add the wheelbarrow. Okay. All right, so that's looking good. All right, so next I would like to add some type of decal. And you may be asking, why add a decal? So decals can be used for several different reasons and in different scenarios. So we have cars here, right? So a lot of times when you're in the driveway, there is some type of oil leak or there's some type of debris. So we want to emulate that. And we're gonna go to objects, decals. I'm gonna scroll down. And the one I like to use is stains. So we're gonna pick a stain. You got different type of stains. You got stain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the cool thing about this is that you're able to change the opacity on these. And we're gonna get into that real shortly. So I'm gonna pick stains 1. And I'm going to drag it here. And as you can see, our stain is here. And you can rotate it if you like. And we're gonna put it right behind the tire, okay? Or it doesn't have to be, it could be anywhere. We're just trying to show some type of sign that, hey, there's a vehicle that usually parks here, and it may be some type of debris or oil leak or anything, just to kind of add some realism to your renderings. So you can change the size of this guy if you want to. I think we're gonna keep it at its default size. And we're gonna change the opacity. We're gonna just bring it down a notch, maybe 50%. Guys, if you're liking this video, please do not forget to hit the like button. All right, so we're gonna add a couple of these. All right, so now we're gonna go to our image. We're gonna click on our image. Let's rename this image, and we're gonna name it rendering 2. All right, so I want to also change my garage glass. Right now it's the same color as the windows. I want to tint these windows out, so I'm gonna go to our material picker, click on our glass, and as you can see, it shows you what glass we have available or what's being selected. And I'm gonna go to materials, glass. So here we have different types of glass. You know, we have our clear, we have our green tint, which what we have right now. We have the clear glass ring 02, and I want to actually add kind of more of a plastic kind of look. So I just remembered that I actually saved this particular material in my user library. So we're gonna go to our user library, and we're gonna do the plastic gloss. So I'm just gonna drag that over. Okay, so now it is kind of a plastic look, but you can still have some type of reflection. And when we do the rendering, you'll see what I'm talking about. Okay. So let's click here. All right, so now we're gonna start getting into the path tracer. Now that we added some context, we added some decals, we added some assets here, and I think we're ready to finally do our rendering. So let's check. We're not gonna mess with the environment much. I believe that this is already set. So what we're gonna do more so is play with the camera and the rendering and the FX and possibly the image size. So right now our exposure is at 1, white balance at 5,500. I believe that's okay. We're gonna stick with that. So let's do our focal length. I wanna be closer. So let's do 35. We'll do 38. So we're gonna do 38 and I'm gonna refresh this. Okay. So now let's scroll down, see what else we got. So our vignetting is at 39%. We're gonna want to do 60%, and that just pretty much darkens the corners of our image. We're gonna pick up our sharpness. It's at 8%. Let's do 25%. And also, I forgot there's one more thing. So before we get too far, I'm going to select this car. Right now it's black. So one of the cool things about Twinmotion is that you're able to change the color of your car, and they have different paint colors for your car. So I'm gonna do a coral. All right, so now let's get back to it. Refresh our image. So 60% sharpness, 25%. Let me check our parallelism. Render. Before we hit render, before we try our path tracer, we're gonna go to FX and we're gonna play around with our contrast. So contrast right now currently is 50%, which is, it's a baseline or standard. So we're gonna go, let's go with 40%, and then we want to boost up our saturation to 60%. And for this one, normally you can put a color gradient on your renderings. You don't have to, it just all depends on the look and feel that you're going for. So for this one in particular, I'm going to go with a color gradient. Instead of BT6, let's do BT7. Okay, so we got that. And right now our image is at full HD. We want to change that to a 4K. We're going to go to details and we're going to check tile rendering. Okay. All right, so guys, hit that like button for me. We're definitely gonna have more tutorials coming soon. And don't forget that you can also get this 3D scene, download this 3D scene on renderreboot.com. It is available to download today. All right, so let's go to FX. Let's go ahead and start our path tracer. So right now we're on real time standard. We're gonna hit path tracer. Okay, so right now our quality is at high, but we're gonna switch that to 24. And also I want to change my max bounce to 15. We're gonna keep the fireflies same. So we're gonna go back to our image. I actually want to do a custom size. We're gonna do 4,000. Okay. All right. So the path tracer is going. And as you can see, a little bit of our detail here with the decals, the stains, it kind of shows that there's vehicles in the driveway or have been in the driveway. And guys, this is a pretty good looking image. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button, and we'll be back with another one.